Hello all, I'm Yeeticides. I've been developing games for about 3 years, and I made a handful of short games. I mostly made games for game jams, but this time I'm developing a game with a bigger scope, and that's why I'm starting this Devlog series. I'm currently working on a multiplayer first-person shooter. I used to work on a similar project a few years ago, but I sadly stopped working on it because of schoolwork and scope creep. With more experience and time at my disposal, I'll try developing a similar game, starting with an arena deathmatch-like game mode. To begin development, I installed Mirror, an API that will help me with the multiplayer stuff and high-level networking of this game. After setting up the scene and network components, and changing the yucky standard skybox to a better one, I needed an FPS controller that could work with Mirror, and that's where my older games come in. You see, I've been working on multiple FPS games before this: Nordy Holder, Noctis, Captive Centrifuge, Thinking with Gateways, and my last game, A Realm Zebel Dreamt Of, all use the same base FPS script and add improvements by each game. So I just took that script and made some changes so that everything worked with Mirror's attributes and network behavior scripts. For now, every client and its character controller has authority on its own actions, but I'll be transitioning this to server-side commands to improve in-game security and to make cheating harder. Speaking of the character controller, it has standard planar movement and also adjusted slope movement, which solves an issue most rigid body player controllers have out of the box with Unity. I also added ladder movement, which was quite simple, but it could use some improvements later. Another feature I added is ziplines, which kinda look like the ziplines in Valorant, but play differently. In my version of this mechanic, the player attaches to the rope on collision and ziplines toward the further end of the rope, unlike in Valorant, in which you use the W and S keys to move while attached to the rope. I'll be adding shooting and combat later, as I'd like to ensure the quality of the movement mechanics first. I want to make the movement diverse and fluid to make the combat fun, so if you have any other forms of movement that could help make this game more enjoyable, please join my Discord server and tell me about your suggestions. That said, the mechanics of a game are as good as the levels in which they are used, so I have to design good levels for this game. For now, I've made a white box level with different rooms and zip lines that connect them, and once I choose a visual theme for the game, I'll replace the white box objects with models to give the levels the character that they miss for now. I'll also be designing levels that reward players who master the movement mechanics. The addition of these mechanics will raise the skill ceiling of the game, which will in turn make it more meaningful to master them. I think combat with different levels of elevation, like ramps and height differences, will make the game more interactive. My objective for this project is to have different maps with different teams, so that every map feels like a different game, and to also have games hosted by players to which other players can join from a list, like the one in Source Games, like Counter-Strike Source and Garry's Mod, where you join community servers. I have some pre-made Cinti assets at my disposal, but I'll mostly be modeling assets by myself to make sure that the game doesn't feel generic. As of now, multiplayer is only available on two builds that are on the same computer, so on a local host. And even if this works great for testing and debugging, it won't work for the general gameplay of this game, so I will try establishing some kind of multiplayer connection. This could be on the local area network, on a dedicated server, or with help from Steamworks. But given the minimal progress I've made so far, there are more important things to do, like the level design and gunplay. So networking-wise, I'd say we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So that is all for now. There is a long way until the completion of this game, but I have high hopes for this project. I hope I'll be able to invest enough time into the development and the devlogs. If you have any ideas that could help me while developing this game, or make it look, feel, or play better, please don't hesitate to comment below or text me. I want to thank you all for watching, and once again invite you to my Discord server. The invite link will be in the description. Also, check my itch.io page, and my older games if you have the time. The link to that will also be in the description. Again, thank you for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you later.